All right, Michael, what's the answer?
All right, so of those others, well, C is pretty good because it does separate the pluses from the minuses. We even liked it so much that we used it in round two. But mm-hmm. it doesn't seem as good to me as A, because A actually does a good job of separating the more heavily weighted points. So I would say A.
So, in fact, that is what our little learning system chose. It chose A. And now, through the trick of animation, I leave you with A. And that is exactly the right answer. By the way, Michael, if you look at these three hypotheses and their weights, you end up with something kind of interesting. So if you look at this third hypothesis that's chosen here, it turns out to have a very low error. You'll notice that the errors are going down over time, by the way, 0.14. And it has a much higher alpha of 0.92. Now, if you look at these weights and you add them up, you end up with a cute little combination. So let me draw that for you. Okay, Michael, so I cleaned up a little bit so that you could see it. If you take each of the three hypotheses that we produced and you weight them accordingly, you end up with the bottom figure.
No way.
Absolutely.
That's kind of awesome. So what you're saying is that even though we were only using half planes or axis aligned semiplanes for all the weak learners, that at the end of the day, it actually kind of bent the line around and captured the positive and negative examples perfectly.
Right. Does that remind you of anything else we've talked about in the past?
Everything. Nothing. No, I don't know. I mean, so with decision trees, you can make shapes like that. And
That's
and the
true.
Fact that we're doing a weighted combination of things reminds me of the neural nets.
Yeah. And should remind you of one other thing.
I'm imagining that you want me to say nearest neighbors, but I can't quite make the connection.
Well, you recall on our discussion with nearest neighbors, when we did weighted nearest neighbor, in particular, we did weighted linear regression, we were able to take a simple hypothesis, add it together in order to get a more complicated hypothesis.
That's true, because it's local.
Right, exactly, because it's local. And this is a general feature of ensemble methods, that if you try to look at just some particular hypothesis class, let's just call it H, because you're doing weighted averages over hypotheses drawn from that hypothesis class, this hypothesis class is at least as complicated as this hypothesis class, and often is more complicated. So you're able to be more expressive, even though you're using simple hypotheses, because you're combining them in some way.
I'm not surprised that you can combine simple things to get complicated things, but I am surprised that you can combine them just with sums and get complicated things, because sums often act very, you know, sort of friendly, right? It's a linear combination, not a nonlinear combination.
Actually, Michael, part of the reason you get something nonlinear here is because you're passing it through a nonlinearity at the end.
The sign.
Yeah. That's a good thing. We should ponder that.